please rise for the academic processional and remain standing for the prayer. Welcome to the 2023 opening ceremony. Emily Hutchinson will lead us in prayer.
Please join me in prayer. Lord, today we pray to thank you for guiding this new class's paths in order for them to be present on this campus. Fill us afresh as we begin this new academic year. We rely on you, Holy Spirit, to recall things back to our minds and to retain new information as it is needed. Enable us to learn and soak up knowledge that is provided through our faculty and peers. Be our mouthpiece as we speak to others. Let the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts shape our futures. Inspire us to be catalysts in the changing of the world. In your name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Students, families, faculty, staff, and friends, please welcome the 17th president of Capital University, Dave Kaufman.
Thank you. Good afternoon, and welcome to Capital University. Hey! On behalf of the entire Capitol family, it's a privilege to welcome you to this special event celebrating the start of the fall semester. To our special guests, and that's you students who begin your Capitol journey today, we celebrate you with this long-anticipated tradition. Together, as our new incoming class, you will walk through Memorial Gateway, onto the campus, and into the Capitol family. I'd also like to welcome the family members, friends, faculty, and staff who are here to celebrate and support you as you begin this next chapter of your life. So welcome, everyone. You'll find that Capitol is a special community. We can provide all the opportunities of a large university with the safety and comfort of this intimate Bexley campus. With 60 majors and over 50 minors, there's no limit to what you can pursue and achieve here. Yet our professors will know you by name. This is a place where you not only have a voice, but your voice will be known and heard. In addition to challenge you academically, Capitol will help you grow as a person and engage socially. Our intent is to simply help you discover and become the best version of yourself. The university offers nearly 100 student organizations to help you network with others who share your interests. You'll also have opportunities to engage with the community and contribute to things larger than yourself. I challenge you to find something you care about, get involved, and make a difference. Your personal success will be measured by much more than your academic success. It will be measured by your growth in character, your commitments, and your advocacy. Your success will be measured by your judgment and your ability to think critically, skills that will be honed by your Capitol experience. As a university, we're well positioned as we enter a new academic year. Our leadership team has established a set of initiatives to support you, but also move us forward. Our focus is on student success and academic excellence. We will continue to innovate the student experience and pursue an aggressive diversity and inclusion agenda. We want to meet you where you are and create a positive learning environment, one where everyone feels welcomed and challenged. Delivering a superior student experience takes a personal commitment from all of us. It takes each of us to create a welcoming environment. This involves celebrating our differences and valuing our unique characteristics. We must accept each other as complete and ensure everyone is appreciated, valued, and respected. And that commitment starts with me. I will ask no more of you than I ask of myself. As a leader of Capitol, I promise to demonstrate high character with integrity behind everything we do. I believe, as Martin Luther King Jr. did, the time is always right to do what is right. Our Lutheran heritage is also important to us. Free inquiry, ask. Critical thinking, think. And servant leadership, lead, are three core values of the Lutheran faith that Capitol University and I have committed to. I encourage each of you to make the same commitment. Ask, think, lead. If you show up every day with a natural curiosity, looking to learn, and committed to leadership, you'll thrive in our program and realize both your goals and your full potential. I promise you that you'll be transformed by your Capitol education. We will empower you with the knowledge and capabilities to be a leader in your field of choice and make a lasting difference in the community where you end up living, working, and serving. Today, you join a special community that offers a superior learning experience, a support system, and a rich professional network. You are now part of the CAP fam, and it truly is a family. You belong here. You can do this. We are here for you. Thank you, and welcome to the Capitol family. It's now my honor and pleasure to introduce our Director of Choral Activities, Dr. Linda Hassler.
Thank you. Welcome, class of 2027. The Chapel Choir and I are excited to see you and welcome you. For over 10 years now, the choir has been singing at this opening session to welcome our first-year students and their families. And it's always one of our favorite audiences to sing for. The piece we're going to be singing for you today is People Get Ready by Curtis Mayfield. I'd like to introduce our instrumentalists and soloists first and then tell you a little bit about the song if you don't know it. So our instrumentalists on bass guitar is our friend and hero, Rika Fanning. On drums is sophomore instrumental music education major Isaac Lutz. On keyboard is the infamous Professor Chad Baker. Our soloists aren't all current Capitol students. Jalen Mitchell was reminding me that it was 10 years ago today that he was sitting where you are now, waiting to hear the chapel choir sing to him. Here he is 10 years later singing with us because A, he loves to sing, and B, Cap Fam is forever. I love your enthusiasm. This is going well. Thank you very much. Second soloist is Gretchen Weber, and she is not a Capital University student and hasn't gone to Capital University. She's a music education teacher and sings in one of our other choirs, and she's here singing today because she loves to sing, and Cap Fam welcomes everybody. So. Third soloist is current student, junior vocal music education major Bailey Richardson. So this piece by Curtis Mayfield and the Impressions has been immortalized by Rolling Stone magazine as one of the greatest pieces of all time. The gospel-influenced classic is part hymn, folk, soul, and has remained relevant since its release in 1965. Part of a long tradition of African-American freedom songs that use train imagery, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. considered this the unofficial anthem of the civil rights movement. It touches people, regardless of their musical tastes or differences. In addition to Curtis Mayfield and the Impressions, multiple artists have made recordings, including Rod Stewart, Aretha Franklin, U2, Bruce Springsteen, Bob Dylan, and today, the Capital University Chapel Choir. The music and themes are timeless, but the magic is also in the lyrics. People, get ready. There's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage. Just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. You don't need no ticket. Just thank the Lord. Now, in this piece, the train in the song means lots of things. It's a train to freedom, a train to heaven, a train to justice. I'd like to suggest there's another train here. It's the train you're about to board today, your college experience, and your place of belonging in the Capitol community, affectionately known as Cap Fam. So, welcome. Get on board.
a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. Don't need no ticket, just thank the Lord.
To save his own.
Have mercy on those whose choices grow thinner, so there's no hiding place on the kingdom's throne.
Get on board now.
Thank you. Speaking of trains, I'd like to suggest there's one more that you could get on board. It's called the choir train. I know, that was pretty good segue, I have to say. But seriously, we have several choirs at Capitol, and there's a place for all levels of experience and training, and auditions start on Monday, and they go through Wednesday. It's very easy to sign up for a time. You just put in the search on our website, choirs, Capitol Choirs auditions, it'll come up. All the facts you need to know and a link to sign up, and we hope you'll consider it. I hear a lot of first years say, I just want to get adjusted first before I join things. I'd like to suggest that the way you get adjusted to this new place is to join first. And that's what we'll do it. So that's my encouragement. Hope you'll get on board the choir train. The second piece we'll sing for you is a traditional piece for the chapel choir. It's a blessing. And there's a wonderful tradition with this piece that any alumni of the chapel choir that are in the room come and join the choir and sing again. And I happen to know that there are some of those alumni. When you've been at a place for 33 years, that's me, you start to have the children of the students that you had before. And I know there's at least two of those parents in the room whose children are here now as first years. What I want you to know is as we sing this blessing, we want to assure you that the Lord will bless you and keep you and shine on you while you're here. And now, alumni of the chapel choir, if you'd come on and join us, please.
Please welcome Dr. Jody Fournier, Provost and Vice President of Learning.
Please join me in recognizing and thanking Dr. Hassler, the chapel choir, and the accompanying instrumentalists and soloists. Please also join me in recognizing the Capital University Faculty Brass Quintet. You are getting a preview of the powerful learning that goes on at Capital and the world-class expertise of our faculty and staff. It is my absolute privilege to welcome all of our new students and to extend this welcome to your family members and guests on behalf of our staff and our faculty. In just a little while, you will pass through our gates on Main Street to signify the beginning of your relationship with Capital University. As a member of our community, you will define yourself by the values for which you stand, by the wisdom on which you will rely, and by the vocation through which you will serve the world. All the while, the staff and faculty at Capital will serve as your guide and champion. We will offer new sets of skills and help you think critically, reason logically, and communicate clearly. In this community, you will find the inspiration to live a life of reflection, a life of action, a life of civic engagement, and a life of service to others. Students, it is my pleasure to introduce you to the faculty of Capital University. These individuals are scholars known for the contributions to their fields, known by the books they have written, by the articles they have published, and by the art they've created and performed. Our faculty are dedicated teachers committed to your growth and transformation. Faculty, please rise. Students, it is also my pleasure to introduce you to the staff of Capital University. These individuals are expert practitioners known for their impact on their professional worlds and the lives of our students. Our staff promote and enhance your learning in our libraries, on the playing field, in the residence halls, in the community, and around the world. Staff, I know you're all over the room, but please stand. Collectively, staff and faculty are passionate about educating the whole student and are deeply committed to learning inside and outside the classroom. We are dedicated and skilled experts trained to promote your health and well-being, intellectual growth, and leadership development. Most of all, we are a community fully committed to your success in your time here at Capital and beyond. Faculty and staff, please join me in welcoming the newest members of our Capital family. Students, we are thrilled you are here. You belong here. You can absolutely do this, and we will help you. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce Beverly Kinnetetter, President of Student Government.
Good afternoon. As stated, my name is Beverly Kinnetetter, and it is an honor to serve as Capital University's Student Government President. I'd like to thank the administrative body for offering me the opportunity to welcome you to your new home for the next few years. As the President of Student Government, I can honestly say that we are so excited to have you join CAPFAM. CAPFAM is all about community. A community that cares deeply about one another. Here, you'll meet new friends who become family. You'll join student organizations that fit your interests and introduce you to new ones, like Creative Writing Club, Chemistry Club, Capital University's Dance Team, or Houseplant Club. The memories you'll make with your CAPFAM during and after class will be irreplaceable. This is a substantial and enthralling chapter of life. For many of you, you'll have the chance to live in a residence hall among your peers for the very first time. You can study abroad, take an internship, or be on the executive board for a student organization. Maybe you'll do all of this. The life-changing experiences at Capital are endless, and I am confident in your ability to try new things and discover your path. Think of all the extraordinary moments ahead of you. The study nights in Blackmore Library that turn into endless laughter, the long runs in Bexley with your roommate, and the opening night of Christmas Fest. These events will be the catalyst for making some of your most unforgettable memories. Now, onto the fun stuff, the academics. College classes can be challenging, but remember, you are fully equipped for this new chapter. It's important to remember that you may make mistakes, but you will learn from them. They're simply part of the journey. Some days will be hectic with classes, homework, practice, and rehearsal, In others, you may find yourself sitting by the fountains with a book for hours. Find your balance and keep going. So, as you begin your adventure at Capitol, let me offer you a suggestion. Take advantage of the wondrous opportunities that Capitol University offers. Go to the football game, ask the question during class, get to know your professors, meet some new friends at campgrounds, go to that student organization meeting you're even slightly interested in. You may just meet your Cap fam there. Welcome to Cap fam.
Years from now, you will still recall your very first days at Capitol. Arriving on campus, the people you meet, and all the welcome weekend activities. Today, we commemorate this new beginning with the ceremonial passage of the incoming class through Memorial Gateway, where students are welcomed into the academic community by the university's distinguished faculty, administrators, staff, student leaders, and parents, families, and supporters, many of whom themselves are Capitol alumni. This procession has become a rite of passage. It symbolizes membership in a community that values broad intellectual pursuit and bold artistic endeavor. A society where all are free to question and to think critically. A culture that relies on diversity and demands inclusion. An invitation to turn thought into action for the good of society. Through these same gates you enter today, you will, in a few short years, accept another challenge. Informed by our shared values and all you have learned, you will make the world a better place. Students, after you process through the gate, cheered on by our community, please meet your families at the fountains to say your see you soon, not goodbyes, before your residence hall floor or commuter meetings. Now, the words we've all been waiting for. I will see you at the gate.
Friends and family, please remain seated for the recessional. The faculty will now lead the incoming students toward the Memorial Gateway. After the faculty and students have recessed, the orientation leaders will direct friends and family to the gate. You may exit out the doors you entered. Thank you. Thank you.